So there were a number of things different about your master's program than our NC State engineering program. I remember hearing some of the horror stories. What was like your one or two biggest takeaways academically and then also personally?
The system in Germany is very different because, first of all, they have different levels of universities, of college. When we say college, for them, the definition of college is like a trade school, almost a higher level trade school. So they have different levels of university. They have basically like a trade school, then a college, then a university. And so your college is more like your practical stuff. You have more project work, more teamwork, less, theoretical stuff. Then you have your university where it's almost all, theoretical stuff. And it's a lot more challenging as far as the level of coursework that you get. So I was in the university echelon, I guess you could say, and the way that the German system works there at that level is that you have essentially all the freedom. You have your homework isn't counted. There's virtually no projects or very little project work, and no quizzes, no midterms, just one exam at the very end. And if you fail, you fail. And if you get a bad grade, you get a bad grade. If you get a good grade, you get a good grade. But it's the preparation is all up to you. And so you have basically 5 months within that semester to prepare, to get yourself ready and take that test. And it is not a joke. It is not a like. I mean, it was. To put this into perspective, I never failed. Never came. Well, I came close to failing one exam at NC State, but here, my first semester, I failed 4 out of my 5 exams, and my parents thought that I was like, they were just shocked. They thought I was like partying too much, and but I did not change my habits at all since NC State. So I was doing the same exact kind of, cookie cutter studying practices and stuff to get through my time in Germany, and it just wasn't working. Because the level was just intense. It was, and I remember at the end of my master's, I told my dad, I was like, if I would have worked this hard studying for my exams at NC State, I would have been a valedictorian, like 100%, no doubt. Like I was so far out of my comfort zone, and it was funny because at the beginning I failed those 4 out of 5 exams, then I kind of rebounded a little bit and I passed most of my exams, so I thought I was out of the weeds of failure, and then the third semester, boom, failed 3 out of my 5, and I was like, okay, I guess I still don't have it together, and I had like a super close heart to heart. My roommate, who was this Italian guy from Milan, who was this brilliant dude, really smart, in the same program as me, and he was there when I was studying, and I was like, dude, and he was kind of, he doesn't really, he's not a very direct guy. He won't tell you if something's wrong unless you ask him. And I was like, listen, dude, you've been there the whole time. I've been studying. Dicking off, like, tell me what am I doing wrong? What do I need to do? And he literally just laid down a whole plan for me. He's like, listen, you gotta start from the beginning. You gotta start with the end in mind. When's your exam? Then you calculate backwards how many days you have to study. Okay, out of those days, okay, and then you take all those days you have to study, you break it up. Okay, you do a practice exam on this day. You get as many as you can, and your goal is to basically finish it within 2 hours by the time you finish studying. So whether you can do problems, all your weak points, you focus that on your problem sets, just completely like engineered this plan for me to get
Yeah,
backstop.
built your own syllabus.
Very intense, yeah, I got through it, and that's why I didn't wear glasses when I started. So I'm kidding, I did, but I did go down a few. It, my eyesight did go down during that time because it was just you're sitting in the library, people lined up to get into the library. There's a line. If you don't get in, you don't get a spot. You can't study. I mean, it's brutal. You can't take your personal things up there. So you have a locker. You can only take a basket with like your basics. You can't take any drinks, no food, just water. Very like, I mean, it's very rigid. Very. I mean, you have to be really. I think the takeaway for me in that master's program was not so much the actual the automotive engineering stuff, which of course I got, but it was the fact that just to organize yourself completely alone, put together a plan, action, go for it and carry that out in terms of studying, knowing yourself, knowing how you study, right? If you're looking at a computer and you're looking through your practice test on your computer, but you get distracted by YouTube, which I did all the time. That doesn't help, right? Because you're distracted the whole time. So I had to actually I started printing out everything, printing out all my exams, closing my laptop completely for hours at a time, and just going through those exams. And for me, going on my laptop was like a reward. And just knowing those things about yourself took a lot of trial and error and help from friends to get to that point. But it was very rewarding. And the interesting thing about the German master's program is at the end you have a master's thesis. All of them do. There's no like master's program without a thesis in Germany like there is in the U.S. It's all with the thesis. And that was one of the coolest things is and a lot of the theses are partnered with companies. So I did mine with BMW in Munich in Germany. And so I did a project improving one of their acoustics issues with related to the hatch of some of their smaller SUVs and smaller hatchbacks. And that was a really cool thing. It was a really nice culmination of kind of my studies as well as it was a nice finished, like a bow on top of the whole cave, of the whole, let's say, box of presents that I put together in my master's.
Yeah, well, and I wanted to kind of circle back too, because I remember you saying in high school, you just kind of picked engineering. You weren't necessarily a super hands-on guy or wanted to code or like be kind of that typical engineer. And then you ended up going into this very, you know, focused program, thesis, masters, and really having to, I guess, not get your hands dirty because it was still in books and theoretical, but really, you know, train your mind to think like an engineer. So you had some of those skills, but you had to put that into practice. What do you think made you, you know, was it just to get to Germany, or was there a different mindset that made you go from, oh, maybe engineering, to this is, you know, a passion of mine almost?
Well, interesting. I wouldn't even now I wouldn't say it's a passion, but it's interesting you say that because when I started failing on those exams, especially that third semester where I thought I was on a good way and then I failed again, I had serious doubts about whether I wanted to do that because I knew that I would have to really get focused. And a lot of the people that were in that program were like real car guys. They were like, you know, tinkering with their cars on the side, or they were even like in the SAE, the Formula Racing team, and they were very involved. They're very, they knew their stuff. They really did. I wasn't one of those guys, and I think the discipline that I developed through that program is what got me through it. Not necessarily my love for automotive engineering. And so, if you ask me, you know, I wasn't so sure in high school, and then I doubled down basically, right, with automotive engineering. I went where I think I felt like my skills were the strongest. So, you know, I did well in mechanical engineering. I knew I liked learning German. And when I did the internship or the co-op at BMW, and I also did an international internship at BMW in my bachelor's for 6 months, I knew that those two things could mesh really well. And there's a lot of opportunity there. And I just kind of went with the current on that one, right? Sure. And that really was the reason. There wasn't any particular passion for engineering in general or automotive engineering in particular. What it did do, and going with that current, I think what it helped is, for example, when I ended up getting my full-time job at BMW in Spartanburg, South Carolina, it was with an international rotational program for which when I applied to, I was, you know, out of... there's really only a handful of other candidates that were as qualified as I was, and they, you know, they were nowhere to be found. Literally, I was interviewing against nobody else. It was just me for that role. So, because the requirement is you have a master's degree, German language skills. On top of that, I have, you know, Russian and experience at BMW. So I was so perfectly, like, let's say, curated for that trainee program that it just kind of fell into place. And ironically enough, after the trainee program, the rotational program, I got I'm in a role now that's more project management than engineering, really.
Mm-hmm.